Dear friends, this is the continuation of our previous lecture.
So if S is a non-empty and bound S set, S is non-empty and bound S set, okay, then since S is bounded means bounded above as well as bounded below. Since S is bounded above, so there exists an element U such that all elements inside the set S must be less or equal to that element. And similarly, since S is bounded below, there exists another element V such that all elements inside the set S is must be greater or equal to that element. Okay. So if S is bounded, then the set looks like this figure. Okay. So obviously all the elements here are upper bounds of the set S, and all the elements here are the lower bounds of the set S. So next result, and that is very important result. Okay. So let S be a non-empty subset of R, okay, and S is bounded above. An element U belongs to R is supremum of S if and only if, first condition, U is an upper bound, second condition, for any epsilon positive, there exists an element U naught belongs to S such that U minus epsilon is strictly less than U naught, less or equal to U. Okay. So proof of this result: given U is the supremum of S. If U is the supremum of S, we have to prove that U is an upper bound, as well as for any epsilon positive, there exists U naught belongs to S such that U minus epsilon strictly less than U naught, less or equal to U. Okay. So since U is the supremum, means least upper bound, so U is an upper bound. So one is true. Okay. Now let us take epsilon positive. Okay. So obviously U minus epsilon is strictly less than U. Okay. Now, given that this is the least upper bound. Okay. So any upper bound must be greater or equal to U. So any upper bound must be greater or equal to U. So this implies is U minus epsilon cannot be an upper bound. So U minus epsilon is not an upper bound of S. Since U minus epsilon is not an upper bound of S, so this implies at least there exists one element inside the set S which is bigger than U minus epsilon. Okay. And this completes the proof. Okay. So now we are going to prove the converse part. So given these conditions, we have to prove that U is a supremum. Okay. Claim U is the supremum of S. Okay. It is already given that U is an upper bound. Okay. So only thing we have to prove that U is the least upper bound. Okay. So if our claim is not true, then if claim is not true, if claim is not true, then there exists an upper bound V such that upper bound V is strictly less than U. Okay. So now we take epsilon equal to U minus V. Since U is bigger than V, so that epsilon must be positive. Okay. So by the given condition 2, for that epsilon positive, obviously there exists an element U dash inside the set S such that U minus epsilon is strictly less than U dash. Okay. Now, what is U minus epsilon? U minus epsilon is nothing but V. So V is strictly less than U dash. Okay. Since V is an upper bound, so all the elements inside the set S must be less or equal to V. But here we have seen that there exists at least one element U dash which is bigger than V. So V cannot be an upper bound. Okay. So that is a contradiction. Okay. So the result is U is the supremum of the set S if and only if U is an upper bound, and for any epsilon positive, there is a U naught belongs to S such that U minus epsilon strictly less than U naught less or equal to U. Okay. And this completes the whole proof. Okay. Now we state another result. And this result is for infimum case. Okay. So let this is a non-empty subset of R which is bounded below. An element V belongs to R is the infimum of S if and only if. First condition is V is a lower bound, V is a lower bound of S, condition 1. And condition 2, for any epsilon positive, there exists an element V naught belongs to S such that V is strictly less than V naught plus epsilon. Okay. Since the proof of this result is similar to the previous result, so we omit the proof. Okay. And this two results are very important regarding our next discussions. Okay. And now we stop here, and in our next lecture we will discuss about the completeness axiom of R and its applications. Okay. Thank you.